Hey, what's up, guys? SportsFan1 here, back with another video, and in today's video, we'll be doing another episode of the New England Patriots franchise. If you watched last episode, I'm sorry. Yeah, it wasn't my best showing, it wasn't our best showing. I threw 5 interceptions with Caleb Williams. But it was against the 49ers. I guess it was kind of come to expect that we weren't going to play very well against them or have a really good chance to win. We are still struggling against the run like we have been all year. But I watched some film. I mean, by that is I always go back and I watch my videos, you know, not like the whole video. I said, I snip it and I try to see, you know, where can I improve? And on the offensive side, it's like I said, try to take what the defense gives you. Now that's easier said than done because you can't see the whole field. I know you're supposed to try to do that, but some people will say it's very easy to see the whole side of the field, and I'm just slow, you know? I mean, there was one route, and I think I pointed out in the video that it was like a fourth down play, and we went for it, obviously. And Tyquan Thornton had a very nice little zig route for a first down easily, and I didn't see him because I didn't look at that side of the field. Sometimes on Madden, you can't see all the routes at once, and sometimes the buttons disappear. And I don't always remember who's who. Like, I know which buttons are, like, the outside receivers because they're usually X and B. But, like, Y, R, B, A, that changes a lot. I mean, especially with the tight end. The tight end could be anywhere between A, Y, and R, B. Same thing with running backs. They either Y or R, B. And that changes between plays. I'm really trying not to throw out excuses. I'm not a great Madden player. I know I'm better than what I have shown. And hopefully as the series goes along, you can see that I am a better Madden player. I'm just struggling right now. But watching the film, I saw things that worked and saw things that don't work. Now, running 4-6 against the run does tend to work. It's just you have to see what formation they're in. And if it's a running formation, run a 4-6, but spread it out. That's something I'm going to start doing, spreading my defense out. And against a team like the Dolphins, we're not going to be pressing a lot because they got speed. They got Jalen Waddle, Devon Achane, Tyreek Hill, you know, and even Mostert, I think, is still on this team. I could be wrong, but, I mean, they got speed. So we're going to be giving them cushion. So we're going to give them a lot of underneath stuff today. That is going to be the game plan for this game against the Miami Dolphins is we're going to give them a lot of underneath stuff. We got to make our tackles. We have to make our tackles in open field because we are going to give them those 5-6 yard gains that might even turn into 12, 15 yard gains, but I'm really going to try not to get beat deep, not going to try to get beat over the top. Offensively, again, we are going to try to get the running game going, and there was a couple of bright spots in last game, though, believe it or not. We had 2 players go up in development trades because we had 2 breakouts last week. The first breakout was a rookie right end by the name of Tarvarius Hicks. He had a breakout, and he actually has 4 skill points. We'll upgrade those in a second. But he got up to star. And now this changes things on him. He's only 22 as a rookie. With this being here, and with those 4 upgrades, I know it's Morales playing him down, but he's a 72 overall. Morales killing him right now, but he's a 72 overall. With these 4 upgrades, we have potential to get up to a 76 already by week 11. And so, with him being star, I anticipate him getting 1, 2, maybe even 3 more upgrades before the end of the season. So he could be very close to an 80 overall by the end of this year, and only a 22-year-old player. So he might be the future at left end for us. You know, I still need a premier pass rusher. I like old Jalari. He's done some good things for us, but he just hasn't been the player I thought he would be when I picked him up. So I think this offseason we're going to try to get a premier pass rusher to go alongside Hicks. But right now, Hicks is that guy. Now, he's wearing 65, and every time he goes out there, he wears 11. I have tried my hardest to change every of these guys. They just don't go into the game for some reason. They just don't. It's a glitch, and I'm hoping that's only for that draft class. I'm hoping that these draft classes going forward aren't like that, because that's just going to be, at some point, we're going to see a bunch of 22s out there or a bunch of 11s, so we're just going to have to deal with it. I've done my best. It's Madden. I don't know what you expect. But yeah, that was a bright spot. And also, Keaton Mitchell is now up to superstar development. After starting the season at normal dev, we had two breakouts, and we got both of them. Now, it was a struggle to get his breakout in the last game. It literally came down to the wire. Like, I got him pretty much right on the dot. But nonetheless, we got him to superstar development. Now, I don't know if we can get him really abilities right now because he's not an 80. We do have short out elite. I don't want that. He's a running back. See, until we get him close in a higher overall, there's really nothing I can get, you know. I really want Jukebox. I don't even see Jukebox. Am I just blind? Oh, there it is. See, I have to be at 85 overall elusive back. So, I think right now... I think just, you know, recuperation or... One of these two I think I'll run with right now. I think we're going to do this one because I like to get that. But we'll change everything once, you know, he gets to a higher overall. We'll probably do that at the end of the season. But yeah, so those were a couple of the bright spots, you know, especially for the long-term future. As for this one here, we got a tough game here. We got a team meeting rivalry match. We lost it in week one. Now we're going to Miami to play them here. Maybe it wasn't week one, but it was early in the season. So... Matthew Judon says, no way I'm letting them hold it over our heads. Bring everything you have today and show us that they can't beat us when we're at our best. Get revenge and beat the Dolphins. Your players have been waiting for this and have 5+ break tackle and +5 play recognition for this week's game. Well, we'll take everything we can get right now. We have a prospect spotlight. Usually these aren't great. Usually these aren't great, but we'll see what this people, they want to look at wide receiver Josiah Anthony. There's reliable hands. We really don't need receiver because we got Ondunze and Judy. Now, Thornton is a decent slot receiver with the speed. He's done some good things for us. Maybe we can get a better slot receiver with better route running, maybe? Let's see what Josiah Anthony has. Again, usually these are never great. You know, usually these guys are trash. So we'll look at Josiah Anthony. There's a left end here that's round 1 to 2 talent. You know, expected to go to the top 5. So he's not a top 5 talent, but he's still a decent talent. This guy's also round 1 to 2. Okay. But we're looking for the receiver. Did I miss him? Here's an easier way. Let's just go to receiver. Josiah Anthony. He's projected to go round 2 and 3. I haven't really... He's a white guy, but that doesn't mean much. He's a 23-year-old, 6'2", 216 physical receiver. He has solid to good acceleration, so hopefully it's good. Agility is good to great. Would love that to be great. Change direction is good to great. Jumping is good to great. Solid. Speed is solid to good. Hopefully that's good. Strength is good to great. So he's not a speedster. He's not going to beat you on speed, Demon. Now, how is his route running? C to F medium route. Well, I'm hoping that's C. C to F short route. That's C. Where's deep route? Deep route not even on here? Oh no, sorry, there's a C. Has B spectacular. This dude looks awful. This dude looks awful. See, I'm telling you, none of the guys that are they say is prospect spotlight. Reliable hands. He has D catching. His B spectacular catch. Maybe that's what they're saying. But I mean, the only grade that I like here is possibly awareness, spectacular, and release. I mean, there could be a lot of B's in here, but it could also be a lot of D's and a lot of F's. this guy's just, yeah, I don't think I'm going to choose him. I mean, you know, if he's still somehow available, like, in round 7, I might take a chance on him, but... Again, like I said, every time there's a prospect spotlight, 9 times out of 10... I'm going to actually say 10 times out of 10, because I've never seen it be good. It's, yeah. So, scouting focus player. Choose focus players. That's right. We actually, I think this is around the time we get to choose focus players. All right, who do I want to know more about? Well, see, left end or right ends, you know, I think we already have, like, you know, getting close to knowing, you know, this guy's a day 3, so we know this guy's horrible. So, I think what we might do is... Yeah, because these guys are going to be done by draft day. So I'm not going to learn more about those. All right. What do we actually need? We got to look at that. What do we actually need? And that Earth Scouts may not actually look at. You know, maybe a right guard or a left guard that we can move to right guard. You know, I like Cole Strange. But he's a 74 overall. He's 26. He may not. I mean, he's just not progressing the way I like him. I mean, his run and pass block are terrible. That's probably why I'm not really getting good protection. I would love to get a guy that's good in both. But I'll take anybody right now over Cole Strange. So I think we'll look at a couple of offensive guards. And then, as crazy as it sounds, I might think about corner because, I mean, Christian Gonzalez has been a huge disappointment this year so far. Now, I still want to keep him, but he's not a cornerback one. Adebo has also been a disappointment, too, with that superstar development. He's just not quarterback one material. So, I need a true number one corner. Hicks is going to be good for us because he's going to just start developing. I still need a right end, but we don't have to take a look at him. Defensive tackle is fine for us. Outside linebacker might be something I might want to look at because Judon's not going to be here for a while, but I could look at that maybe in free agency. Safeties is fine for right now. So let's see if we can find a couple of offensive linemen that look good, and maybe we can, you know, see some diamond in the roughs, and either a corner or an outside linebacker. Yeah. I only get 3, but I get 3 more in the offseason, so we could do guards and cornerback or outside linebacker, and then whatever we don't do now, we can do the other in the offseason. So let's look at guard. Let's do 1 right guard and 1 left guard. This guy actually looks good for round 2 to 3. And actually, these two guys look really good. To be honest, I mean, I know not really scheme fits, but actually, this guy looks amazing. Could potentially have a lot of it. I want to know more about Gil right here. I mean, I know these guys are, like, looks like proven. I mean, this guy has worse Bs, maybe a couple of As. But I'll look more at him later. Because that's 75. I mean, look at Gil. He has potential. I mean, the run block isn't, you know, fantastic. You know? But, I mean, it could be really good ratings for athleticism. But run block's only a C. Okay? Yeah, but look at the pass block. And we like the pass block a lot. And we like the pass a lot. He could potentially have A awareness, A impact block. He has a terrible lead block, but he's a guard. Potentially have A pass block finesse, A pass block power. Just the run blocking is just not going to be there, but he has A stamina. But in 3 or 4, if he has more of those A's, this could be a diamond in the rough and potentially have a hidden development. I want to learn more about Gil here. I want to learn more about Gil for sure. I'm also intrigued about these guys here. I might learn if I can't get him to 100% by draft day in the offseason. I might try to learn more about one of these two. All right, so let's look at right because we can always move them. Not a lot of guys out there that, I'm going to try to find a nice, well-rounded guy, though. Gil's not really well-rounded, but Ty out of Michigan potentially has, you know, inside, what is that, IBL, inside block? Impact blocking, actually. Could potentially be an A and have B pass and run, so that's more well-rounded. Same thing with this guy. virtually the same type of player, basically. Just one's from Ohio State, one's from Michigan. They're both round 3 to 4. All right, let's look at both, and see who has potential to be good to great, solid to good, great to elite. Well, that's almost that could be potentially a lot of elites there, especially with agility and change of direction. That's pretty good you want that in a guard, especially also with acceleration. All right, so let's look at the Michigan guard. That should be good as well, but not as many of elites. I mean, it's still not horrible, but I think I want to learn more about the Ohio State guy. It sucks, I'm a Michigan fan, but it's Madden. So I think I want to learn more about Cartwright. It's also round 3 or 4. We could potentially get a couple of, like, steals in, like, the later rounds. So I want to learn more about Sean. I'm going to say that's his name. It's Sean Cartwright. All right. Oh, wait, does it go away after... All right, so... I hate that. All right, so let's look at left outside linebacker. This guy's a run stopper, which we do need. We need more run stoppers. He's a scheme fit. He's round 3 to 4. Like I said, I'm not really looking at round 1 or 2 to 4. I'm trying to find like hidden gems down the board. And this guy's out of North Carolina. He's a scheme fit. He has potential to have B block shed. He already has B pursuit. Has potential to have A tackle and A zone coverage. But we're seeing. C is actually not that bad. That's like around 70, 75 around there. If I know correctly. Let's keep going down the board. Anybody that's like hidden? Not that I see. I think we'll... I'll look at right outside right now, but... I'll keep Herschel in mind. All right, right outside. All right, there's this guy out of Wisconsin, around 3 to 4, DeMarco Roth, who has B block shed, but has potential to have A tackle, A zone, and A pursuit. Okay, looks like a corner. Looks like it's deep in corners. Not round 1, round 1 to 2. Alright, is anybody down the board that looks sort of okay? No, looks like he had to get one early. So we'll probably do corner in the offseason. This guy looks good. Out of Arizona, he's a scheme fit. Man to man. He may not be a cornerback 1 material. He's 6'3", though. Okay, I'm intrigued. 6'3 has apparently been usually pretty good. But he only has solid to good speed. See, if it was elite, man, this guy would have been very good. But, I mean, I'm looking at his things. He has B-man, B-zone. So that's at, like, around 78, 80. Oh, Danny. Why couldn't you be faster? Why couldn't you be faster, man? Now this guy is A man and B zone. B to D press. He's only 5'10", though. I want a taller corner. What about this Darren guy? 6'2". A to C catching, could be D man, has B man, B press. Could have solid, I mean, great to elite speed. See, that's what I'm looking for. Potentially has B zone, but I do run a lot of man blitzes, so if he doesn't have great zone, we can work on that. We can develop that. How old is he? He's 22, okay. Has a lot of... Could have a lot of great two elites in there and a lot of goods in there, too. Strength, I'm not really worried about corner, but great two elite speed's good. Jumping is... Hoping is good. Same with change of direction, but agility and acceleration could be elite. At worst, it's great. So I do like that. So he's a good athlete. It's around 1 to 2. Do we do the corners now? I think I'll wait. I think I'm going to do the... Was it Herschel or was it Oh, it's gonna be Roth. All right, so I want to do Roth now because he could potentially have a lot of A's. So we're gonna do Roth. I mean, this guy is could also have elite speed. Okay, this is a great athlete. Could be. All right, yeah. So we'll do Roth. Now, can he pass rush? Potentially could it be a good zone, but can he pass rush? As D finesse move, he has B block shedding. But the finesse moves and power moves. So this guy probably won't be able to pass rush the quarterback. But he's a run stopper, which is what we need. We need run stoppers. Alright, so we'll do Roth here. And then the two guards. We'll do Sean and Gil. And see if we can see some hidden hidden gems here in the later rounds. Now one of them is round 1-2, I think. Oh no, wait, that was the corner. So we'll see after this game and when we advance and see if do we find some hidden gems. That'd be cool if we can do that down the board. Let me know what you guys think about those picks. Did I make the right picks? And I'll probably do more in the off season. But we'll probably in the next episode go through prospects and all that. Alright. The only other thing we have is upgrade players. Because of the things, we have like 4 upgrades for Hicks. And I think it's going to be all into run stopper. Just because that's what we have struggled with. You know? We could upgrade speed rusher. But for right now, let's get the run stopper upgraded. Alright, we'll do a power rusher for the next 2. Because that's the scheme. Alright, so right now, he is up to a 75. So he went from a 72 to a 75. So now this is workable now. This is workable. Yes, the finesse moves are terrible. Alright, Duggar, run support. And it's actually a scheme too. So everything's pretty much on the defensive side is going to run. It's going to run because we are terrible at it. Keaton Mitchell, elusive. It's just going in there because I want to get some more traits. He's not getting affected by morale, so he's a true 79 overall. So we're close to 80. Who's next? Dalvin Turner. Man to man. Now he's up to a 79. Plus 2 to man. I like that. 85 man, 76 zone, 92 speed. And then the last one is our kicker. We'll just do power. Plus 2 to kick accuracy and plus 1 to power. I got 96, but his accuracy sucks. But since I'm controlling it, I really don't think it matters. All right, without further ado, I know we're now 23 minutes in. Let's get into the game. But this is our future I had to worry about. Because if I don't do it this week, I think I lose the focus player. So I had to do those. And it's snowing here in South Florida. Did I just see that? Okay, no. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I was wrong. Tell me that did not look like snow out there. We're in South Florida. But there's no Florida here. There's no snow on the field, and it's an open stadium, so I could have been wrong. But I swore that looked like snow. I'm gonna have to review the picture. They have a superstar returner who's wearing number 11, so that's a rookie. Let's see how Tua Tagovailoa has done this year. He's done fantastic. Just like what Brock Purdy was doing, just a little more yards. 2,200 yards, 17 touchdowns to only 2 picks. And my guess is a lot of those yards are going to Tyreek. I want to know about that superstar returner. Oh, it's Neighbors out of, I believe. Yep. He's a 91 overall already. With 94 speed. Wow, another speedster. That's all Miami gets is speedsters. I think he's out of LSU. And let's go! Hicks gets a sack. We sent the blitz and we spread. Maybe that's how we're supposed to do defense right here. Oh, thank God he stepped out. I missed that tackle. But we have a chance here to get off the field. If we can get a three and out, that would be perfect. And I'm going to send the all-out blitz here. I'm going to send in the all-out blitz. We could. This is the only time I'm pressing. And it works out. Devin White comes in and gets the sack. And we get a three and out. Two sacks. And with the injury to Cash, Odunze is going to be doing punt returns. I might have to change that because I don't want him to get hurt. Because I'm going to actually change that right now. Because kick returner we have, first we're going to take a look at Caleb Williams. Obviously those 5 interceptions brings his interception total up to 20, and he had no touchdown passes. So, you know, like I said, I would like to limit our interceptions from here on out. Pro Bowl type season, yeah, but minus the interceptions. Now, I gotta probably do this in the main menu, but for right now, because right now our kick returner in the last game was Marcus Jones with 93 speed, and he did fine. He did fine. And I'd rather have Jones out there than Odunze. I mean, I know Jones is probably also out there on defense, but I'd rather have Odunze stay healthy. And we're gonna start off with a little run here to Keaton Mitchell. And that went nowhere. Let's see if they're going to expect a read option. They're loading the box. Well, they were prepared for that for sure. Now it's 3rd and 11. I don't want to go 3 and out either. Let's see if we can get a first down here. Looking at Gesicki's route here. Oh, and I fumble. Alright. I don't think anything was open. Yeah, 77 just didn't hold his block. I mean, I guess I was looking at Gesicki. I mean, I guess it looks like I did have one-on-one coverage with Odunze, so maybe I could have just threw it up, gave him a chance. But Gesicki took too long. I didn't like this because I don't know. I just didn't like it. I didn't like it. I feel like that corner would have came in and knocked it away, and it wasn't a first down anyway. Judy was covered. I would have thrown that into coverage. Nothing was open. I mean, I know I took away his route, but it would have been right here. Maybe that would have been the smart play, but I don't know. So I was like, you know what? Let's just take the sack. Because I throw an interception by trying to force it. Let's take the sack. And he fumbles. And now they're set up in the red zone, basically. Nothing was open there. But you know what? Let's see if the defense can come in and get a stop. Looks like they're going to try to run it. This will be a time to spread it out. They run up the gut. That's fine. You gotta be kidding me. A-chan. Okay, this isn't Derrick Henry. We gotta get him on the ground, guys. Why can't we tackle? Like, Is A no longer just a wrap-up tackle? Like, the sure tackling? Because in last Madden, it was A. You press A, you hold down A, it was just wraps-up tackle. He doesn't try anything like strip the ball or hit stick. It's just wrap-up tackle. Does that no longer work? I mean, this isn't Derrick Henry. This is Devon Achane. First, I try to tackle him with Kyle Duggar. No, that's a Debo, actually. But he tries to grab his arm instead of his whole body. So he just gets shoved off like a Derrick Henry. This is not Derrick Henry. And then he breaks the tackle of Gonzalez. I mean, all right. This video isn't going to be a lot of complaining. I complain a lot about this game. They're going to run again. I am going to get past, but I am. Most easy touchdown. All right, time to regroup. A run defense isn't going to be magically good overnight, so... Alright, let's try a little play action pass here. See if we can get Schuster's route. Oh, the safety did bite. We are going to have Schuster's route, but it's a bad throw. Oh, Mitchell. Whoop. We'll take that run. We'll take that run. All right. You know, if we can run the ball, it will help our passing game. Alright, we'll take that. A little 9-yard run there. Oh no! He's hurt, yet he's celebrating. Looks like he's fine. Oh, now he's hurt. Oh no! I hope he's okay, man. I hope he's okay, because that would be really unfortunate. Wow, what a dot! And now Cole Strange is hurt. He's already bad. Now we're going to get something even worse. Mitchell has a bruised knee. We'll use Stevenson for the rest of this drive. I don't want to have him get reached. But what a throw. What a throw from Caleb Williams to Odunze there. Off the back foot was a dot. Let's see what Stevenson has to offer us. All right, nice little run there for Ramondre. Gets his first and goal. Broken ribs. Trent Brown is, for some reason, the substitute, even though he's our starting tackle? Interesting. Actually, you know what? We're going to run it again. We got the block. Touchdown. Let's go. Just be smart. You know, why force it? Run play worked before. Let's run it again. But man, what a throw though earlier in this drive by Caleb. I can't stress that enough. How normally that throw, I either throw an interception because it's off, or you know, I just don't throw it on time. Maybe it wasn't on time, and maybe it wasn't, you know, the greatest decision to throw that ball, but it was an absolute dime to Odunze. I mean, it had to be in one spot and one spot only, and it was there. Well, I did a run formation because that's what I thought that... Now, see, this is another run formation. Oh, it was a play action, but I'm going to run another 4-6, and I'm going to do cover 3 bear. I am going to guess pass. I am going to put it, like, underneath, but... Oh, you got to be kidding me, man. We missed a tackle. What a horrible angle that was. How do I stop the run? I've run out of options. Can someone in the comic section tell me how the hell do I stop the run? Like, what do I have to do? I'm desperate, man. I'm desperate. I need someone. If someone is watching this, can someone in the comment section below tell me, without being rude, how the hell do I stop the run? Because I honestly don't know how to. Oh, Uchiha got hurt. Has a bruised shoulder. I'll keep him off right now, but... Alright, Stevens is still in here. Oh, and Stevenson breaks one. Alright. It's gonna be a breakout game for you for Stevenson now that Mitchell's hurt. How injured is... does it show that? Because, like, he could come... He could have come back. With the injury, he still has his speed. His awareness is down. I don't know if it's always been down. When will he return? In 2 quarters. Okay, so he'll be back for the second half. That's fine. That's fine. I mean, Stevenson isn't a terrible running back, so he's not a bad option to go to. Well, that was a bad run. But so far, 4 rushes for 47 yards and a touchdown? It's not bad. It's not bad at all. We'll try to read option again. Now they're actually running the ball very well. They could bite. Yep, they do. Gesicki's going to get that block. And we're just going to slide here. Nice 11-yard run for Caleb. I will say this, offense is looking better. They're double-teaming Jerry Jeudy. I'm going to send Ondunze deep as well, because that safety cannot cover Schuster or Ondunze both. Which means we should have one-on-one. Now I am testing... That was a bad throw anyway. I am testing Ramsey, I just now realized that. Probably not the best idea to test Ramsey. Okay, but it's only first down. It's second down now. I tried a little curl route for Stevenson, like right in the middle of the field, and all outs fails. Well, all outs fails. Catch the ball. Let's go, Stevenson. Oh, thank God. Sean Tucker's in the game. The bright spot from last year. Nothing was open, man. Oh, that's unfortunate. We're going to take this to the end of the first quarter. I think I might actually kick a field goal. What's the wind like? Oh, it's going to change on this way. We got a field goal kicker that can hit from deep. He has 94 kick power. Actually, 95. It's 96 now, I think. Right? We're going to see if we can do it. We're going to see if we can do a field goal. Let's see. It's a 60-yarder. Although we are against the wind. Well, we're going to see if we can make it. We're going to see what his limitations are. Oh, I didn't... Nope. I didn't get full power. He almost made it, too. How close was it? Oh. So. If I actually had it at full power. Because I was just under it. If I had it either full power or even the extra power, I would have made it. Okay. So even against the wind, he can kick 60-yarders. I'll keep that in mind. I just gotta be better on the timing. Man, that's unfortunate, though. What the hell is Gonzalez doing? Was that his supposed was he supposed to do that? I tell him to go to the outside. Was that? Oh, okay. He was supposed to be there. Okay. Never mind. Never mind. Waddle is just too fast for Gonzalez, who has 94 speed, by the way. Alright, we're going to send an all-out blitz here. We're going to try to sack the quarterback. Oh, Solari can't make a tackle. Got the screen shaking here. Away team receivers are hidden during the play, so I gotta know these. Okay, so Judy is X, Schuster's Y, Douglas is A, and Odunze is B. Okay. Oh, wait. Alright, so not all. Okay. I'm not the greatest of seeing the field, but when I finally make a good read, and it's a good throw, and then they drop it. Like, come on, man. Come on. I'm struggling here, man. I'm struggling. Okay, I'm throwing it back to him. What the f- That's not part of... That's not even part of the momentum either, is forcing bad throws. I mean, this is a great read. Schuster's wide open. This was just a bad throw for no reason at all. For no reason whatsoever, this was a bad run. I mean, a bad throw. Come on, man. We should have had two first downs by now. If both those passes were completed, we would be across the 50 right now. Instead, we're looking at a three and out. Come on. Two inaccurate passes for no reason at all. We were not pressured at all. I can't do anything, man. I can't. I mean, what am I supposed to do there? Those are three passes that should have been completions. Let's go, Gonzalez. I need that to be a pick. I need that to be a pick, man. I'm spamming Y, but he knocked away. I'll take that. I'll take that. I'll take that for sure. Damn. Those curl routes, man. Those curl routes. Those curl routes always get me. Oh, you gotta be kidding me, man. How do I stop all these missed tackles? Hicks has got to make that tackle, man. How are these guys hanging on to the balls when I have those same things and they drop it? I mean, it really doesn't matter what defensive plays I pick because they're just... Peppers! Let's go! That is what we needed right here, Peppers. We needed that, man. We totally needed that. Now we have to go score and try to work the clock as well. Nah, I feel like that could have been better. We are actually going to put shoot clock on because we get the ball start the second half. I'm running one more time, but I am trying to go 2-for-1 here. I am trying to go 2-for-1 here. Let's see if we can get at least 5 here. Oh, they were ready for that. They were ready for that. I'm going to run a little hurry up offense because... Oh my god. I didn't see him. I thought he went with the outside receiver. Okay. You're serious, right? He did not go with the receiver. I thought he did. Nope, he just stayed there. They ran zone. They ran zone. See, I thought it had Judy wide open. I can't have anything nice. We can't have anything nice. Probably should not have ran it on second down knowing that it didn't work on first. Yeah, that probably was a mistake. 2-minute warning. For sure. For sure, I can understand that. Just a bad play call. Just a bad play call. Oh my lord, wide open. All right. Well, let's see. Got a minute 51, all 3 timeouts. We get the ball start the second half. We get a touchdown here, touchdown at half, and we're right back into the game. Take that. And did he step out? No, he didn't. No, he didn't. Okay, so roll early up. We're taking a shot. Let's go. Judy! Oh, that was a touchdown. You gotta hang on to that, buddy. Come on, man. That was actually a really good throw from Caleb. All right, we'll take that. Makes a 3rd and 1. I'm gonna little hurry up. All right, completed that. And we have to call first timeout because Michael Wenu gets hurt. Another offensive lineman. Great. This is not good at all. We have 2 backup guys out there. That was terrible. See, I was trying to get the ball out quickly because I'm feared that we're going to be pressured immediately. All right, let's try to run a little screen pass with Stephenson. Hey, get the block there. Did not get... Okay. I won't call timeout right now because I don't want the... What is up with the freaking broken ribs in our offensive linemen? Hey. Ooh, that took a lot of time off the clock. Shoot. Snap the ball. Snap the ball. I should have called timeout. I didn't think it was going to take that much time off, though. Doesn't matter. What a throw from Caleb Williams. Let's go. Wow, what a throw from Caleb. Caleb's made some couple of good throws today. Also made some bad throws, but he's made some good throws. And we needed that score before half. That was a great throw. I mean, I had to be in one spot. I had him angle him towards the back, or it wasn't really back of the end zone, but towards the, you know, side of the end zone. And it was just a perfect ball because it kept the cornerback going deep. All right. So it's safe to say they're going to run the ball here. So I'm going to send an all-out blitz. And I'm going to guess from up the middle. If they pass, good for them. Yeah, they're just going to run the ball. Okay, you're not breaking Jordan Davis's tackle. I'm sorry. We're going to go into halftime. We're going to get the ball start the second half. We're only down two scores. So it could have been worse. But we really need to figure out how to stop the run. And I don't know how to do it. So, the running game has been working, but we are going to just try to throw it deep. That's going to be our main thing, is throwing it deep. Not going to try to throw it deep every play, but it might need a couple more bombs to get back in this game. And this one is, they've been running a lot of outside, so I'm going to try to get the outside run stopped. All right, but this is a must-touchdown drive, though. We got to make it within one score. Why did we hesitate? Oh, shoot. I knew he was going to hesitate. I probably would have just stayed in the end zone. Okay. We're going to start off with a little... Hey, Keaton Mitchell's back. That's right. Hopefully he's okay, and hopefully he can help us here. Ah! That was set up perfectly. I got bumped in the backfield. Oh, wrong guy. Shoot. Fuck, no. Alright, we're just gonna reset play. I'm just gonna run it. Alright. That was a good throw. Wish you got more, wish I threw it sooner, but we're gonna run my favorite play, middle high low. Oh, this might actually be a good play to Judy. Oh, yep. He beat him again, I think. He drops it again. I thought he had him. I really did. Gesicki, I might have had. Yeah, he would have been in front. Juju's route, not really. Rome, not really. Keaton Mitchell, that cornerback would have gotten it. But see, I thought I saw him in front. He kind of was. He just dropped it. He had him in his hands. Oh, it was knocked out. It was knocked out. Just good defense right there. Well, this was a much touchdown drive, and we have to punt. Oh, what a terrible punt. That was a terrible punt. I don't know what the heck that was. I was trying to kick it lower, trying to get it deeper. Maybe that's why. I really can't do that. And now they're set up in great field position. Well, we're going to start with an all-out blitz here. Oh, my God. You are not serious. You're telling me Jordan Davis couldn't make a tackle there. Judon gets a sack, or half a sack. Now it's 3rd and 5. We got to get off the field here. Let's go, Hicks! Let's go! His second sack of the day. And we are going to make him punt. We can do that for the second half. We might actually come back here. We got to get the offense going, though. They're going to try to angle it. All right, we'll start from the 13. It's better than being down at the 1. Okay. Okay, that's a better run, a 5-yard run. Better than a no gain. I'm going to send Skisicki on a streak because I'm trying to get Mitchell's route. Oh, yeah, we got it. First down. With the 2 offensive linemen out, we might not be able to run the ball inside. It might have to be a lot of stretch plays. I was trying to step up and run. I just did it too late. None of these routes are getting open. Oh, Judy, get back. Yeah, that was not good. That was, not good at all. I was waiting for Gasicki's route, but they had it covered. Maybe Suster's route up the seam, like, angle it, like, right, you know, here. But knowing what this game is, it would probably angle it over here, and this guy would be going to get it. I saw Judy, I'm like, you know what, he's in front of both of those, if I can have him come down. But see, every time I do that, they never do it. They never come back to the football. They keep running up. See, he comes back there, but it's way too late. It was 3rd and 14. What am I supposed to do? You know, just run the ball and punt. We're down 14. I'm guessing we're up to middle. If they pass it, good for them. Let's go. It worked out. It actually worked out. We got a hold in the 3. I don't know what that does for us. We're down 14. That'll be 3 scores. 17. Could use a turnover. Let's go, Duggar. Judah nearly had another sack. And we're going to send that all-out blitz again. We're going to send that all-out blitz. Judon gets a tackle for loss. We held him to field goal. I mean, defense has stepped up in this half. We just need the offense too, man. Well, it's about to be 14 to 20, or it's about to be a 17-point game. Oh! I pressed X. How did I not block that? Oh, we needed that block. Oh, but now we're down 3 scores. But you know what? Still got time. Time for what exactly? I don't know. All right, you know what? We're going to run middle high-low. I love this play. Judy's route, 9 times out of 10 works. Didn't work earlier. Let's see if we can get it this time. We got to start taking some chances. Nope, I'm going to hit it sicky. Okay, we'll take that. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. And now he gets hurt. That was a 9-yard gain. He broke the tackle. Don't break the tackle. Just go down. He had a 9-yard gain, and now he's hurt. So that was a double whammy there. I mean, I'll take the game, but that almost was a first down. It's all right. It's all right. Third and inches. All right, we're just going to try to run here. We need a yard. This should get a yard. Or even an inch. I mean, this has to get us a first down. Yep. Sicky hip. We'll deal with Irv right now. I don't want him to get, you know, too injured. Oh, no, 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 why can't I see these guys? Why don't I see these guys until it's too late, man? I mean, seriously, how do I not see him? He's standing right there. I just don't, I for some reason can't see him. I'm just blind. See, I see Irv's route. I'm like, oh, he's wide open. So is Mitchell's route, by the way. Could have just hit Mitchell's route. It would have been an easy gain. I mean, what was it, like second down? I can't tell. I don't think it says on the field, but... yeah, off the play action. He was wide open. Just hit Mitchell. Take what the defense gives you. That's my philosophy I wanted to go with. Instead, I see a bigger route, I think. You know, say, oh, yeah, Irv Smith's route's good. Idiot. I'm an absolute idiot. Oh boy. What the hell? Okay. Flag, please be holding. We can't make tackles. We can't stop the run. I can't do anything right. I don't understand what's going on. Oh, it's coming back. Thank God. On Jalen Waddle. Still going to be first and 10. Just don't understand, man. I just don't. Devin White gets another sack, though. We've been sacking Tua a lot today. Defense has stepped up. It's been the offense today that's been terrible. We're going to end with like 40 interceptions this year. That's the end of the, we're going to need a monster fourth quarter. You've got to be kidding me. Got to hold him to 3. Got to give it a 3-score game if we have any hope. I think it's too much to overcome, but... I mean, how does he break all these tackles? Like, how can we not tackle? I gotta look this up. I'm going to. After this game, off camera, I'm gonna figure out how to tackle. Should be fundamental, but apparently it's not for me. I'm going to figure this out, because now I'm pissed, and that's a touchdown. How is that a touchdown? I don't know. If I was throwing that ball, that's intercepted. Plain and simple. I'm going to figure this out. Because I'm pissed right now. I mean, this is every single game. Like, I don't know what else to do. There's got to be something I'm doing wrong that was work. Because, okay, I understand in each Madden's, what works in one Madden may not work in another. But from what I understand is the previous, like, four Madden's, A was always wrap-up tackle, the sure tackle button. You know, if you need it, just sure tackle, doesn't strip the ball, doesn't hit stick, doesn't do anything other than just wrap up. It was always A. Or if you're playing on PlayStation, what is it, X? But for whatever reason, every time I do that in this game, they break the tackle. Like, they just do a little arm tackle. They don't wrap up. You know, I don't know what else to do. So I'm going to have to look this up. I'll figure it out. It's just, it's right now it's going to be painful. We gotta start taking some shots here, though. That's a good play right there. God, he can't even complete a simple curl route. Yeah, obviously I have to go for it. Oh, let's go, Judy. Another touchdown to Judy. It's still too far out. We're gonna go for two, apparently. Can't get it. What would that brought us? A 16? Oh, I guess it would have been a two-score game. I can see why. Alright, we're going to try an onside here. Oh! So close. We're going to guess around the middle. You know, if we get burned on a pass, that's fine. But right now, we got to start taking chances on defense to get quick stops. And never mind, because we just can't seem to get him in the backfield. This is literally every game. I just don't understand. Thank you. Oh my god, man. I mean, I feel like there's no reason we should be this bad. You know, obviously a lot of it's me. I'm just not a great Madden player, but I mean, at the same time, we really should not be this bad. I mean, I'm not saying we're the best team in the league. We still have a lot of holes, especially on the defensive side. But the team that we have right now, I just don't believe we should be this bad. But we are. Here we are. You know what? But this is a long-term rebuild. This is not just a one-season rebuild, and, you know, this is a franchise series. And I hope to do 10, 15 seasons of this. So, you know what? First few seasons are going to be tough. And then we get, you know, to the brighter spots of it. I don't know how the hell I completed that, but I'm not complaining. He finally caught a ball. Let's go. Well, he's got more, but can we get another playoff for the 2 minute? Oh, we should. Snap the ball. What the hell? Didn't want to throw it to him. I did not want to throw it to him. I hit the wrong button. I panicked. I should just threw it away. See, I'm trying to score quickly. I don't even know why I'm still trying to come back in this game. This game's over. This game is over. See, here, what was I trying to do? I was trying to throw over to X. I was trying to throw X. I hit the wrong button. See, you know, maybe I can come back and I'll throw it to here. That worst is incomplete. Instead, I threw it right to the defender. That's going to be game. I'm not going to call timeouts or anything. 45, 20 is your final. I've threw three more interceptions. Like I said, we might throw four interceptions here. We might have a Jameis Winston season. Defense, it did show more spots. I just, you know what? I got to do some homework and figure out how do you stop the run in Madden 24. There's got to be ways you can do it that I'm just not doing. So, like I said, I'm going to do some homework. I'm going to try to figure this out. And hopefully going forward, it'll be better. This should be the final play of the game. Not going to call a timeout, so that's going to be the final play. I'd be shocked that they snap the ball. Oh, they are going to snap it. We're going to fall to 3-7. Actually, on the bright side, we might be able to get a good player in the draft if we have a low draft pick. We do have two first-round draft picks, by the way. I think if I remember correctly, so. While we suck again this year, it should help for our future. You know, start getting talent early, build a foundation. You know, we got a franchise quarterback. We got a franchise receiver core in Odunze and Judy. We got a franchise running back in Keaton Mitchell. Just need to upgrade the offensive line and then the defense, man. If we can get one, like, premier defensive lineman, you know. Hicks, I really like. He's coming on nicely. I like that. We got two new injuries, though. And I think they're both on the offense. Cole Strange and Awanu are both going to be out for 4 to 5 weeks. So that's going to be unfortunate for us because that's going to hurt our offensive line going forward. We fall to 3-7. I don't know. We're going to get something bad for this. Oh, great. If it wasn't worse already for morale, we get minus 10. If it wasn't bad enough, we get minus 10 morale. All right. Let's advance to week. And let's see about those players. You know, I'm curious about those players that we looked at. Can't remember who they were. Okay. Left guard, it was Gill. We're only at 65. Really? They didn't give us anything? Really? Did they do anything with these guys? Got the 95 here on this guy. So maybe only did one. I guess it was whoever was the top guy, but we know more about this guy's B awareness, A impact block, B lead block, B pass block, A pass block finesse, B run block, C run block power, which is not horrible. And A to B. This is a well-rounded guard right here. This is what I'm looking for. Someone who could do run and pass. 95 Scott. If we can get him to 100%, if I can know his... He's got to be a worse 2 to 3 talent. So he's better than what the projection is. This could be a steal we can get in round 3 to 4. You know, round 3, maybe 4, you know? I know what his projection is, but... Okay, Sean. Okay, Sean. And then it was a right outside line. Left outside right? It was... No, it was... this guy. He didn't. So we only did one. Okay. So maybe do one a week, maybe, I guess. So I guess we'll continue to look after each game, like after each week. So... But that guard is looking, I forgot to add in favorites. I'll probably add into favorites off camera and start, you know, doing a few scouting. But we got the Browns up next, who are 0-10. So if you think our season's bad, the Browns are trying to do what they did a few years ago. And I think, what was it, 2016? Around there, where they went 0-16? They're trying to do it again. So, oh boy. I really want to beat the Browns now, because I don't want to be the first team to give them their first win. So... Alright, that's going to do it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm going to figure this out, guys. It may not be immediate, might not be right away, but I'm going to start doing my homework. Just got to stay with it, guys. Stay with it. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you all in the next one. Don't forget to like, subscribe. Comment down below, what you guys think should I do to stop the run? And please be respectful. You know, please don't be rude. I'm not a great Madden player. I know it's apparent. I don't need to be told I'm a bad Madden player and I suck. I already know that. So, hope you guys enjoyed again. See you in the next one.